starting from mobile. Okay, and then when he goes to the iPad version or a more smarter version of his phone, you enable loading of all these stuff like the images, the JS. Okay, but for that, of course, you have to detect which kind of device it is. Okay, so start with the mobile, a very basic feature, provide the basic features, then add or rather decorate your site so that the smartphones or iPads are able to render it and it is more fancier on that, and the users are, you know, it's good for the user experience. Then again, plan it for the desktop or whatever range of devices you want. Okay, so you start from bottom up, you grow instead of graceful degradation. Okay, that you design for your desktop and then you design for your iPads and iPhones and whatever phones. What you do is, and then by doing this graceful degradation, what you end up is you still keep on downloading the stuff though you do not render it. Instead, if you go the reverse way, you keep the stuff to the minimum first. So only when required, download it. Okay? So that solves my problem of basically downloading content. And of course, then my site would be much faster on my devices, right? So using mobile first approach, designing, like that's a planning and analysis and designing approach, and conditional JS loading. Okay, for conditional JS loading, what you do is basically have your media queries, or you can have some other techniques to decide when it is required and then download it. So with both of these, what you do is build up a site which actually builds it up on depending on the capacity of your device. Right? So that these together actually are, and most of it is also there, these two form the part of progressive enhancement. So which is the reverse. The second problem was that, let's take an example of BlackBerry devices. When we were solving a problem or we were working on it, we found that we decided, okay, of course we had to plan a lot on it, that above 320 we would expect the phone, or let's say 480, we would expect the phone to be smart enough so that it supports gradient effects and round corners, and then it we can make, you know, good use of CSS3 properties and render a fancy site. But what turned out actually was, to our surprise, or not surprise, shock, that though the resolution was 480, we did not have good support for CSS3 properties. So the site broke, it was not rendered correctly, then it was... So what do we do in this? We have to understand whether the browser that it is being rendered on, whether it has that capability to actually process a CSS or understand a CSS, right? So we could not just rely on resolution. We had to rely on something else. What was that? What we did, we used server-side detection. Okay. Server-side detection is basically, you use, there are tools available. What we used was Wordful, okay? So it takes in the user agent string, and depending on the data, whatever the values it has on in its database, it keeps it updated with the latest device user strings. Depending on that, it returns your set of capabilities, and there is a range of things, you know, you can actually make use of. Example, with the user agent string, you know the device, what kind of resolution the device has, the screen width, the screen height, what kind of JavaScript support, whether the device has JavaScript support or not, okay? Whether you have CSS3 support on the browser. So these are the capabilities we actually used, because RWD did not fit in totally, or it wasn't our solution totally. So along with RWD, which we just used for responsive or a fluid design and adaptive design, you also had to use server-side detection, which actually enabled us to understand the actual capability of the underlying device on which the site is being rendered. So using this, and RWD, we actually were able to solve a lot of problems. So though the screen resolution may be 480, but if there is no CSS3 support, there was no use putting all that stuff there, right? So what did we do? We interpreted this information to actually control the markup that was being rendered on the device. And then we ended up serving a simpler version of our site on these kind of devices. Of course, there are n number of devices. You could actually shortlist few and then process according to the capability. So you don't have to bother whether it's a BlackBerry. What you have to bother is about the CSS3 being supported or not, right? So there was a combination of capabilities we used to actually control what kind of markup we are going to render. So this approach, RWD with server-side detection, okay, along with progressive enhancement is what we thought was good enough for us. And that's what we call as a hybrid approach. It is taking the best of all these stuff and putting on and solving a problem. You just saw the hybrid approach that we have used and was helpful for us. That is progressive enhancements. And start with a simple design first, make it work, serve it, check if it works properly, check the performance of your site on low-end devices, then go on decorating it. And that really helps because you don't have to actually go for, like as Akshita mentioned, go for that, you know, go on a toss with big fancy designs and then try to degrade it on your mobile device. That is not really a good way of doing it. Rather, you don't know which content is important and which is not, right? And then combined with server-side detection, just because we saw some conflicting results and some few things which we could not handle it at the client side only. For example, if your device is, like, let's say you have the script tag, right? No script and script tags. You can handle a couple of things, or conditional things over here also. So for example, I have a button on which I want to display a form. If my script browser supports JS, I don't have to do anything at the server side. I just click and show. This is for desktop, for example. Now, for some reasons, JS is disabled. What do I do? I don't see anything. I just gave it a demo, if you remember now. So, I rather render a form. And I support the form submit here. I can switch these buttons conditionally using script and no script. So there are a few things we can do at the client side. So I render the same UI, just because JS is not enabled, I rendered a submit button instead of just the icon or something, and then instead of showing it on click of that, even on the client side that is using JS, I use a form submit. I go to the backend server's app, right, and then process or render a form there, from there. So all these techniques basically are just to make your site work in whatever possible conditions you can.